Hi everyone, it's Jennifer from Fiberflux. In this video, I will show you how to crochet the Agnes lace cowl. This is a very pretty chunky lace cowl and it works up very, very quickly in super bulky yarn. And for this project, you'll need one skein of Lion Brand's Wool Ease Thick and Quick or a super bulky yarn that recommends an N hook on the yarn label. You'll need a 9mm N crochet hook, a tapestry needle, a pair of scissors, and as an option, a ruler or a tape measure to get the desired circumference that you need. So let's get started. The finished cowl is 8 inches wide and has a circumference of 22 inches. However, if you want yours to be a little bit bigger, you can simply work more rows of the pattern. The finished cowl over here was made using the raspberry colorway of the Wool Ease Thick and Quick. For this tutorial, I'm going to be using the Wool Ease Thick and Quick in the oatmeal colorway. It's kind of a tweedy off-white with some pretty texture and flecks throughout. So we're going to begin by making our starting chain, but first we need to put a slip knot on our hook. To make a slip knot, wrap the yarn around your fingers to make a loop, bring the yarn behind the loop, reach in with your crochet hook and bring up a loop. Our starting chain is 14 chains. To make a chain, wrap the yarn around your hook and bring it through the loop. That's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, and 14. You'll want to make your starting chain fairly loose, not too tight, or otherwise it'll draw your project in. To work the foundation row, we're going to work our first, this is a series of V's, double V's if you will. So in the fifth chain from the hook, this loop here does not count. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. In the fifth chain from the hook, we're going to work 2 double crochets, chain 2, 2 double crochets. To make a double crochet, wrap yarn around hook, insert the hook into the chain, bring up a loop, wrap yarn around hook, bring it through the first 2 loops, wrap yarn around hook, bring it through the last 2 loops on your hook, make another double crochet, then chain 2, 1, 2, and then work 2 more double crochets, and we're doing this all in the same chain here. So 1 and 2. So it'll look something like this. Next, we're going to skip 2 chains, 1, 2, and in the next chain, we'll do the same thing. 2 double crochets, chain 2, 1, 2, and 2 double crochets, all in the same chain. Next, we're going to skip 2 chains, 1, 2, and in the chain after that, work 2 double crochets, 1, 2, get a little more yarn here. This project goes through yarn very quickly because it's bulky. It's a great way to use up yarn, and if you don't have enough of one color, you could also do stripes. And it makes a great stash busting project as well. Okay, so we've worked 2 double crochets and we're just going to chain 2, 1, 2, and then 2 double crochets, all in that same chain. Okay, we're going to skip 2 chains, 1, 2, and in that very last chain, we're going to just work 1 double crochet to finish off the row. Okay, so our foundation row is complete. It should look something like this. You should have 1, 2, 3 of these V's across, okay? So let's move on to row one. To work row one, we're just gonna chain 3, 1, 2, 3, and turn our work. Now we're going to be stacking our V's. So we're gonna have a V here and then a V. So we're gonna work right into this chain 2 space from the previous row. So they'll be stacked. If you go back to our cow, you can kind of see how they're stacked a little bit, okay? So we're gonna work 2 double crochets, chain 2, 2 double crochets. Same thing we did in the previous row, but right into this chain 2 space from the previous row, okay? So 2 double crochets, 1, 2, chain 2, 1, 2, and 2 double crochets, all in the same space. Okay, so we can see what we've done. See how they're stacked right on top of each other. Okay, let's get a little bit more yarn here. Okay, we're gonna do the same thing into the next V. 2 double crochets. Chain 2, 1, 2, and 2 double crochets. Okay, and then in that very last V, we'll do the same thing. 2 double crochets. Get a little more yarn. Chain 2, 1, 2, and 2 double crochets, all in that same chain 2 space from the previous row. So you should have 3 across, similar to the previous row, okay? To finish off the row, you're going to work 1 double crochet in this turning chain space. Now, whenever you're working any kind of V-stitch, whether it's this kind of double V that we're doing today or a single, the turning chain kind of will lay on its side, so you need to kind of just feel around for it and look for it. So we're just going to work 1 double crochet in this turning chain space. Okay, to finish off the row. So it should look like this so far. It's nice and chunky, and we also already have a couple of inches that we've worked, and we've only worked 2 rows. So you can see how quickly this pattern works up. So what you're going to do to finish your cow is to keep repeating the row we just did, row 1. If you go back to the written pattern in the FiberFlex blog, it's row 1. So keep repeating row 1 until your cow measures 22 inches. You can measure as you go along or the desired. You can also try your cow on as you're working the pattern to see what is the best fit for you, because sometimes a size that works for one person doesn't work for someone else. So feel free to try your cow on as you go along to get the best size for you. So we're going to set this aside, and then we're going to work on seaming our cow. This is worked flat, and then we're going to seam it. So let's move this aside and seam our cow. So once your cow is as long as you want it to be, either the 22 inch circumference or whatever length you decide, you can go ahead and work your very last stitch, and then we're not going to fasten off. We're going to leave the hook on the yarn, okay? So go ahead and sandwich the 2 pieces together, just like that, and we'll weave these ends in when we're finished. I'm gonna just zoom out a tiny bit so you can see everything. Okay, so go ahead and insert your hook so that both layers are kind of sandwiched together, okay? Now you're gonna wrap the yarn around your hook and bring it through. Just like that. Now turn. And probably one of the most common questions I get on the FiberFlex blog and the Fiberflux YouTube channel is how to seam and how to get a nice even seam when you're seaming lace. Now you can try seaming, which we're going to do today, just seam across as it stands. Or if you're having trouble getting a nice even seam, one that doesn't look loopy or stringy or sloppy, you can also try working a row of single crochet stitches across your last row, and that will give you a nice edge in which your seam can hang on to as you work your seam. So we're going to do the written pattern on the Fiberflux blog says that you can either work a slip stitch or a single crochet seam, and they're worked the same way except for the stitch used. So what you're going to do is insert your hook into the first layer like this, insert your hook into the second layer, wrap the yarn around the hook, and bring up a loop. If you want to do a single crochet seam, wrap the yarn around the hook and bring it through both loops. If you want to do a slip stitch seam, insert the hook the same way into both layers, wrap the yarn around the hook and bring up a loop, and then bring this loop through the loop that's already on your hook, just like that. So that's the difference. They're very, very similar, but you're just going to work it like a single crochet or work it like a slip stitch, whatever you choose. So go ahead and repeat this all the way across. I'm going to do the slip stitch seam. There is a slight difference when it's finished. The slip stitch lays a little flatter. The single crochet will create kind of a ridge. Some people like that appearance. Some people do not. It's completely up to you. A total personal preference. So just work the hook into both layers of your project. There we go. Bring it through both layers. And then we're just going to do this all the way across. So I'm going to work this till we're almost to the end, and then we'll rejoin at the end of our seam. So just keep seaming across and we'll rejoin towards the end. So once you're finished, you can go ahead and just fasten off like I've done. And then this is going to become the inside of your project. So you're just going to flip it out. And actually, I would recommend checking out your seam before you fasten off. I kind of peeked at mine before I showed you. But it is a nice sturdy seam. You can kind of pull it apart. It's pretty strong. So once you're happy with your seam, and if you don't like your seam, feel free to go back in, pull it apart, and redo it. There's no harm in doing that. You want to have a nice, strong, neat-looking, sturdy seam. That's very important in any seamed project. So we have a tail and we're going to weave that in. I have a tapestry needle here, and with these super bulky yarns, the larger your tapestry needle, the better. It'll just make your life a lot easier. So go ahead and thread your tapestry needle. And once you've examined your seam and everything as well, you can turn it back inside out. And then just weave the ends. I like to come in one direction with my end. Like this, pull it all the way through, and then come back in the other direction, and that will lock that end in place for the most part. It's not foolproof, but it certainly helps. So you can remove your tapestry needle, and then whatever's left of your tail, just trim off. You can save these ends for the birds in the spring or to stuff a toy or a pillow or something like that. I never throw my ends away. So once everything looks good and you're happy with it, you can turn your project back right side out. And our seam looks great, our project looks great, and we're all finished. So that is how you crochet the Agnes Lace Cowl. Thanks so much for watching, and be sure and click the red subscribe button to get all the latest Fiberflux video updates. Thanks again.